Boot sector corrupt. No operating system found. Windows failed to start. In other words, you're screwed. No matter what the issue is, if you can't boot up Windows, your files are usually still there. If you just could boot up another temporary operating system to save your precious files, right? I mean, that sounds too good to be true. Or does it? Nope. Here's how you do it. What we need is called a live disk on CD or USB. Most live disks are based on Linux because it's free and flexible, but there are some Windows-based live disks. But they are harder to build because you need an original Windows license, of course. So for the sake of simplicity, I'm going to use a Linux-based live disk that of course can rescue files on Windows installations as well. One thing I have to mention is, if you're watching this video after your PC doesn't boot anymore, you will need a second PC to burn your live disk. These live disks don't replace your Windows installation, and they won't leave a trace once the computer is shut down again. They are just temporary. There are many live disks available. I'm using one called Ultimate Boot CD. You have to download an ISO file, which you burn onto a CD or a USB stick. Windows can do this with internal tools. Just insert an empty CD or DVD in your CD or DVD burner. Right-click on the ISO file and choose Burn Disk Image. If you don't have a CD or DVD burner or just want to use a USB stick, download a software to make a bootable USB stick, like Rufus, for example. Insert your USB stick and select it, choose the ISO file of Ultimate Boot CD, and then hit Start. All the files on the USB stick will be deleted before the ISO is copied to the USB stick. Once your boot medium is ready, insert it into your PC and restart it. Your PC should now be booting automatically from your Ultimate Boot CD, or I guess Ultimate Boot USB, but if it doesn't, you probably have to change settings in your BIOS to change the boot order. Every BIOS is different, so I can only show you how I get into my BIOS, but hopefully yours is similar. If you have trouble, try finding your manual of your motherboard or try to Google it. While the PC is booting up, I press the delete key repeatedly until the BIOS shows up. Then navigate to the section in your BIOS where you can change the boot order and place your DVD drive or your USB drive at the very front. Now your PC will first check these drives or ports for a bootable system before it boots your hard drive. If everything went correctly, your PC should now be booting from your Ultimate Boot CD. You get a ton of tools for system repair and diagnosis, but what we need right now is parted magic. So select it using the arrow keys on the keyboard and press enter. It usually takes a few minutes, but eventually you should reach this desktop. Connect a USB drive to copy your files to, and then in the upper left corner, click on File Manager. This is the equivalent to Windows Explorer. The left panel lists all connected devices. You should see your hard drive and your USB stick here. Select your hard drive of your Windows installation, navigate to the files you want to rescue, and then copy them over to the USB stick. A progress bar on the bottom will show your progress. When you're done, close all windows, and then, like you would in Windows, click on the icon in the lower left corner and choose Logout. Then click on Turn off computer, and now you can hopefully enjoy your successfully rescued files.